हरे हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा। सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द संडे फीस्ट प्रोग्राम। आई सीक द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ ऑल द असेंबल्ड वैष्णवाज हियर एंड ऑल्सो दोज हु आर वर्चुअली अवेलेबल ऑन द इंटरनेट और वेर एवर। आई सीक द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू सो दैट आई कैन स्पीक समथिंग। टुडे इज़ अ वेरी ऑस्पिशियस डे ऑफ द रथ यात्रा ऑफ श्री श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा। So we'll be discussing on the pastimes of various pastimes which took place during this Rath Yatra. So as we were seeing this small drama and the dance, we saw that how Lord Jagannath comes out and gives his mercy on this special day. Otherwise it is a custom, it's an old custom in Jagannath Puri, that not everyone is allowed to enter the Jagannath temple. You know, only Hindus specifically are allowed, non-Hindus are not allowed. But the Lord is compassionate, he doesn't discriminate, and he comes out and gives his special darshan to all the devotees and all the people who are in general. So briefly, if you look at what this Rath Yatra is all about, so Jagannath temple actually represents Dwarka Dham, and the Gundicha temple represents Vrindavan Dham, and the gopis, they are bringing Krishna. They are missing Krishna for so many years. Krishna was in left Vrindavan and he was in Dwarka, so they are pulling him back to Vrindavan. That is what this whole pastime actually signifies. And why Krishna is pulled? Krishna is pulled by gopis' love for Krishna. And also their purity, their heart is so pure that Krishna wants to go back to them. So we see, yesterday we celebrated Gundicha Marjanam, and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally taught the devotees how by cleansing this Gundicha temple, which signifies our heart, so by cleaning this temple, how we should clean our heart. How if our heart is pure, then the Lord will come and reside. We don't want to go and stay in any house which is not clean. We also like our surrounding, our house, it to be very clean. Similarly, the Lord is teaching us that by chanting the holy name, now we can purify. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's most special gift which he has given is the holy name, the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And not only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but if you look at all other religions also, the holy name is the only thing for this age of Kali Yuga. So this particular festival is the festival of distribution of mercy and compassion. The Lord comes out and he distributes his mercy and compassion irrespective of your caste, your religion, whatever your background is, he's ready to give this special mercy. Now when it comes to mercy, and you know, only mercy is not the entry, it's not the ticket which you can take and say that okay, we can enter the dham. Yes, without mercy, if you go to the spiritual world and if there is a counter and they ask for a ticket, so there will be two counters. One is the counter of endeavor, what efforts you have taken, and then there is a mercy counter. So to go to that mercy counter, we have to first put in efforts. Without that, the ticket of mercy will not get. Or sometimes we may say that, okay, I am taking so much of efforts, and we may become proud that, oh, that I am doing so much. I am doing so much of service, so much of chanting of the holy name. But that alone is not sufficient. Then the mercy factor is also important. By our efforts, we should be able to please the devotees and please Krishna, then only we can enter. So if you look at this Jagannath Rath Yatra pastime, the devotees very enthusiastically they are pulling the rath, they are pulling the rope and pulling the rath and trying to bring the Lord in their heart. And we also see in the Damodar Leela, which comes in Kartik, there also the same concept is there. Yashoda Mai, she is also trying to, you know, tie Krishna with the ropes. But those, what is happening, that always it is two fingers too short. And the Acharya says that what are these two fingers? One finger represents the efforts or endeavor, and the second finger represents the mercy. So today we will discuss the life of three kings and see how these three kings, they have put this particular concept of efforts and endeavor and mercy, you know. So first we will discuss about, from Chaitanya Charitamrita, we will discuss about the pastime of King Prataparudra. So this King Prataparudra was not an ordinary king. He was a great king, very powerful king of Orissa. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was residing in Jagannath Puri, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu departed for the South India Yatra. He decided to go there. And the king approached Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya and asked him that who is this great personality? And he started inquiring about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because the king, he had natural affection for the spiritual personalities, the saintly personalities. Of course, he did not know at that point of time that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. He thought he must be one of the saintly personalities. But he approached and he said that, I would like to meet him. So Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya explained to him that he's in a renounced order and he will not meet any king or any royal personalities, because that is not as per the rules and regulations. So he may not meet you. But King Prataparudra was very, very eager and he said that, please do something. Let me have at least one opportunity to meet Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya told him that, okay, once Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes, let me put one petition to him. Let me try. But meanwhile, he told King Prataparudra, when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes back from South India Yatra, he would like to have some solitary place, you know, very quiet place where he can stay, reside. So King Prataparudra started with his first service and he made the arrangement of one house of Kashi Mishra, which he felt was very appropriate for Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So if you can see that Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya had already initiated the first service for King Prataparudra, for Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So that was the first thing he did. And once Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes and Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya approaches Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and says that there is a great king and he's eager to do a lot of service for you and the devotees. He would like to meet you. So Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, as he was expecting, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu becomes very angry. And he says that, how can you ask this question also? Because you know that I am in a renounce order and I cannot meet any such people who are engrossed in material activities. So the king is doing so many activities. He has to take care of so many things in the kingdom. So he is involved in so many material activities also. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu refused and Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya had to communicate the same thing to King Prataparudra. Meanwhile, King Prataparudra's one of the ministers was Ramanand Rai, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu during his South India Yatra met Ramanand Rai there, and he gave him the instruction to come to Jagannath Puri. And Ramanand Rai was also the minister of King Prataparudra, obviously he had to put in his resignation from his role of a minister. So now we see that, you know, when you are working in any organization and you are doing very well and you put in your resignation, how tough it is to get out of the organization. You have to really give so many reasons and sometimes compromise. You have to sometimes give partake the salary, you know, you have to give some of the salary also. All those things happen. But King Pratap Rudra, when he heard this from Ramanand Rai, he was very happy. He just said that, oh, you want to come and serve the Lord? I'm immediately relieving you from your services. And not only that, he gave him additional bonus so that he could go and serve very peacefully, nicely to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now, we don't get such kind of employers now who will take bonus that, okay, you are leaving. The employee has to ask from the new company that, okay, I am leaving from that organization, please give me some more salary. You know, it's a joining bonus which they have to ask. But here was the opposite case. But we see in the same Chaitanya Charitamrita, there is a case of Governor Nawab Hussain. When Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, they wanted to quit and leave and come, especially Sanatana Goswami. Rupa Goswami had already gone from that place. But Sanatana Goswami really had to go through so much of things, because Nawab Hussain did not want, because they were very well qualified. Not only they were great devotees, but they were very good ministers. So he did not want to leave, and he had to actually imprisoned Sanatana Goswami. So that is the case. The two contradictory, two different things we can see. One king and the other king, how they are behaving. So Lord Chaitanya, so King Pratap Rudra, that way immediately relieved him. And Ramanand Rai was very happy when he came to Jagannath Puri, and he immediately came in front of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he started glorifying King Pratap Rudra. He started glorifying that how wonderful this person is, how king is. And he engaged me in the service. That is the prime duty of a king, that ultimately the whole praja should be engaged in the service of Krishna. So that is the main aim. So when Ramanand Rai told this to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very pleased. He said that very nice. And he said that this king will have lot great fortune because of his serving the devotees. So now we can also learn from this particular incident is that how, if we want to reach or enter the heart of Krishna, that cannot be, we cannot approach Krishna directly. We have to go through the devotees of the Lord. So here Ramanand Rai was pleased, and by his seeing his pleasure, his happiness, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was pleased. So this was like first, you know, mercy kind of thing the king got. But still, in spite of all these things, he was still not very happy, King Pratap Rudra, because he did not get the opportunity to personally meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So he decided that, you know, if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not meeting me, giving me darshan, then I have to end my life. So he expresses his emotions, his feelings to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. And Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya at that point of time, he says that have patience. Don't give up so fast. You know, there will be a time and you will get the mercy. So it is how important it is to have such great personalities, such spiritual guides in our life. In our sadhana, when we are practicing, many times we chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, and we are told when you come in Krishna consciousness, ki isme pura bliss hai, you will get happiness. But we don't experience. Sometimes initially we may feel a lot of happiness, but then that happiness sometimes is not there. And then we feel that kuch farak padega ya nahi padega. And we become very morose. So that time, you know, our mentors or counselors, they tell us, you know, don't worry, this happens. You know, it's a wave of devotion. Sometimes you will go up, sometimes you will go down. But just continue. So like that, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya encouraged him. Then King Pratapudra makes one more attempt. He writes a letter to the devotees, asking that, you know, that I cannot be living in separation from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Please do something. So then, when this letter comes, all these devotees, they come together and they said, what need to be done? Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is, anyway, he has said no. So all these devotees, you know, they approach Chaitanya Mahaprabhu again, and this time Nityananda Prabhu comes forward and he puts the request to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. By this time, because of the services which King Pratapudra has done, his heart is softened further. So on Nityananda Prabhu's request, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there is a whole pastime of this, but we'll not go in details. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, after getting this request from Nityananda Prabhu, he says that, okay, at least I'll give my garment, you know, which is Mahaprasad, I'll send this. So let King Pratapudra have my garment and let him be satisfied with this. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sends this, and King Pratapudra is happy for some time. He gets, at least I am able to worship now, you know, he is at least favorable to me. So he becomes happy. But after a period of time, again he feels that, you know, that satisfaction is not there of seeing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So now again he approaches, and this time Ramanand Rai, so you can see the devotees also, they are also using strategies. You know, first time Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, second time Nityananda Prabhu, now Ramanand Rai, he approaches Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because it's dar lagta hai na, you know, when you are approaching a senior authority, and you know, bar bar wohi cheez jaake bolna hai, that same thing you are going to tell, that he wants to meet, then he may chastise. So now this time Ramanand Rai approaches, and this time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's heart is further softened, and he says, okay, you know, I'll not meet him, but I'll meet his son, because son is the representative of father. So it is as good as, you know, meeting the father. So this time the son of King Pratapudra, he is called, and he comes and meets Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and seeing these features of this, features of the son of King Pratapudra, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu remembers Krishna, and he feels very happy and ecstatic, and he embraces him. And this son of King Pratapudra, he also gets the love of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, love of Krishna. So he comes back to the kingdom, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, King Pratapudra, sees him, and he feels so happy that my son also got mercy, but I have not got this mercy. But of course he is not morose because of this. Now you can see here that this King Pratapudra, his minister Ramanand Rai, he gets mercy, his son gets mercy, so many other devotees, they are getting appointment and meeting with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally there. But in spite of being a king, very powerful personality also, he is not getting that mercy. Now, you know, imagine, you know, a powerful personality can do anything. He was a king, and he could have very well, you know, said that, you know, get out of this place or whatever. He could have acted in a very different manner, but he did not. He just continued with his attempts. And so there are so many further things. Chaitanya Charitamrita gives more details. But on the day of Rath Yatra, the Lord Jagannath and Baldev Subhadra, they are brought on the chariot, and the king comes there, and very spontaneously the king starts brooming the road. He puts sandal pulp water, and he starts cleaning the road in front of the chariot. Now when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sees this, he becomes very, very happy. Now we have to understand this king Pratapudra was not, this was not a planned activity that, okay, let me show to this world that how humble I am. You know, sometimes we do that. That, okay, let me, in Rath Yatra, let me catch hold of, we are searching for the broom. Kab milega, and then I'll also start doing this. And there are fights sometimes for getting the broom. But we are missing the point. Of course, we have to, externally at least we try to be humble. Then sometimes we will internalize that humility. But King Pratap Rudra was not doing any kind of show off, like, you know, sometimes today's politician we see, they go to some poor people's house and they say that, okay, I'm having dinner. Then there are photographs, clicks, you know, all those kind of things happen. But this was not that kind of a mood. Neither he was taking a selfie in front of the chariots and with the broom cleaning and all those things. So it was not like that. So it was the pure intention. His intentions were very, very pure, and that is what was pleasing to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So this was the first installment. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was becoming more and more happy with Pratap Rudra, and he started giving. So the first thing which he received, this was a basic turning point for King Pratap Rudra. So sometimes we, in our devotional life, we get turning points. We get some special opportunities to serve. Now, what are these special opportunities? That will come when time tells. But when he does this, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives him the special vision. So during the Rath Yatra, there was a like kirtan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dancing ecstatically, and there were seven groups which were formed, and different devotees were heading and performing this kirtan around the Rath Yatra carts. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dancing in each of this group, and each group felt that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is dancing with us only. But only King Pratap Rudra and Sarvabhama Bhattacharya, they could see that what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's was Leela was happening. So that was the first installment he got. And during this kirtan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was becoming so ecstatic that devotees had to form circles around so that, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is protected. Nobody enters and, you know, touches him, or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is safe. So there are three circles, they were formed around Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he is dancing. So by different devotees, Nityananda Prabhu, Srivas Thakur, and the third circle was by King Pratap Rudra and his team. So this is the origin of first crowd control service in our temple and many places. Actually, this crowd control, very thankless service, especially Sunday feast we see and the festivals, they had to really push people around, and you know, nobody is happy, but the authorities have told them that you have to perform this service so that the things go smoothly. But you know, other devotees, they chastise that, who is he to stop me, who is he to come between me and Krishna? So but thanklessly they were doing this service. And in fact, one of the ministers of this is a pastime, small pastime, you know, he's watching that King Pratap Rudra is watching this ecstatic dance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Srivas Thakur Prabhu, he was standing in between and he's also watching. So this minister, he sees that, array, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not getting the darshan, and this Srivas Thakur is standing in between. So he taps on his shoulder and, you know, request him, thoda side ho jao, you know, let king see this darshan. Now he did not know who is Srivas Thakur. So Srivas Thakur sees couple of times, he looks back, but you know, this fellow continues to tapping on his shoulder. So Srivas Thakur finally turns and gives a tight slap on this fellow. So, you know, he becomes angry. Now this situation also we see sometimes, you know. And at that time, immediately King Pratap Rudra intervenes. He said, no, you are actually fortunate that, you know, you are getting a tight slap from this Srivas Thakur. Of course, we can't imitate this, and we can't go on slapping others. So, but that is the mood of King Pratap Rudra, and he was trying to even show to his minister, his servants also, that what mood we should approach the devotees. So that was the thing. And at one point of time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is dancing, and in his ecstasy he falls down right in front of King Pratap Rudra. Not near Nityananda Prabhu, not near Shivastakur or Sarvabhum Bhattacharya, but in front of King Pratap Rudra. And King Pratap Rudra immediately picks up the Lord. You know, it's an instant reaction. But as soon as the king touches the Lord comes in, he's come out in his external consciousness, and he becomes very angry. Externally he's angry. He's just trying to show that he's angry. But he becomes so angry. And at that point of time, King Pratap Rudra becomes very fearful that I have done some mistake now. And he again becomes very fearful. At that point of time, Sarvabhum Bhattacharya again. Sarvabhum Bhattacharya is like a counselor, you know, for King Pratap Rudra. And he tells, don't worry, you know, the Lord is angry externally, but he is happy. So don't worry, at right point of time, you will approach the Lord and you will get his mercy. So, at one point of time, the Rath Yatra, it comes, the procession ends, and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he goes, enters Gundicha garden, and he's taking rest in the same spiritual ecstasy. He's taking rest, and at this point of time, Sarvabhum Bhattacharya tells King Pratap Rudra, now is the time, now you give up all your kingly ornaments and garments, and you wear the Vaishnav attire, get into a simple Vaishnav attire, dhoti, kurta, and now you go and see Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So when he gets this instruction, again, this is again the right time Sarvam Bhattacharya is giving the instruction to King Pratap Rudra what he should be doing. And the Lord is taking rest, King Pratap Rudra enters the temple, enters the garden, Gundicha garden, and he approaches the Lord and starts massaging the Lord's feet, and he starts reciting the verses from the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, and he starts reciting Gopi Geet. And when he comes to the verse, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is very pleased. When he starts hearing this Gopi Geet, he is very pleased. And he says that, go on reciting, go on reciting. I'm very happy. And when he comes to the specific verse of Tava Kathamrutam, the Lord, he just wakes up and he says that, you have made my day. And he embraces King Pratap Rudra. He embraces King Pratap Rudra. And by his embrace, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's embrace, King Pratap Rudra becomes ecstatic. And he achieves that love of Krishna. And he asks the king, who are you? Who are you? You have pleased me. Tell me, who are you? And this is a very tricky question for the king. If he tells, I am the king, he may feel that what happened earlier during the Rath Yatra, you know, the Lord became very unhappy and he became angry. Now if I tell that I am the king, then I may become angry. He may become angry. And if he says that I am not the king, then I am a devotee, then that also may be wrong. So again, the king says, I am just the servant of the servant of the servant. So this is not, again, the external consciousness. Many times we also say that we are the servant of the servant of the servant, but we don't act like that. But here, his mood was right from the beginning, was that same mood of servant of the servant of the servant. And then Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reveals special darshan to King Pratap Rudra and tells him that you should not reveal this to anyone. So that's the way he achieves the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And after that, then devotees organize, because many devotees are tired. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that now we should organize for prasad for everyone. And there is a wonderful description of prasad. How, what kind of prasad? So Chaitanya, this King Pratabrudra, he organizes prasad for all the devotees. Yeah, because he had offered prasad to bhoga to Jagannath at Balagandi. So he organizes prasad for all the devotees. So it is not like that, okay, now I have achieved the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, achieved the mercy of Krishna, now I can relax, I can do the... No, his service continued. And he organized this prasad for everyone. So Chaitanya Charitamrut describes, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami describes a detailed description of the prasad which was served. And verse after verse, you know, the description is given. So we'll not go in those details, because otherwise all of you will feel that, no, when the prasad will come, and Sunday feast prasad will come very soon. I don't want to come in between. But that is how Jagannath and Mahaprasad has a wonderful, a close connection. Of course, devotees have a special loving relation with Mahaprasad. So from this pastime of King Pratabrudra, this in Chaitanya Charitamrita, three principal qualities we can see. We'll say that three D's. So first D is the desire. So this King Pratabrudra had very strong desire to see the Lord. And not only to see the Lord, but and he wanted to serve the Lord and serve the devotees of the Lord. So on one hand he had this opportunity, other hand he had his kingdom, his wealth, his power and position, and he could have just enjoyed this kingdom and this power. But he did not. For us also, we have a choice. We have, everyone has a desire, some or the other. We cannot be desireless. Either it can be a desire to serve the devotees and Krishna, or we can have a desire to enjoy. In our life, we face both these things. In every situation, we have some or the other opportunity will come, whether to enjoy, whether to serve. And we have to make the choice. The choice is with us. We cannot say that, okay, let Krishna decide. No, that free will Krishna has given to us. That is the greatest gift Krishna has given to us. So, King Pratabrudra had this great desire to serve. The second D which we see from this pastime is the direction. No? Guidance, as we see that how King Pratabrudra was taking guidance of Damodar Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya and many other Vaishnavas. So always this guidance of devotees in our life is very important. We see this from various kings also. Earlier kings, they used to take decision based on the directions or the spiritual guidance given by there are various saintly people which are there. We see this from the life of Shivaji Maharaj also. Shivaji Maharaj always used to take guidance from Sant Tukaram, Sant Ramdas. So he used to take guidance from them. So for our life also, any important decisions which we are making in our life, we need to consult. We have to consult our spiritual guide that how this will affect my future life. Will I be able to continue my service or increase my service, or will I be going away from my service? So that direction, because already we have in our life, we have so many responsibilities. Responsibilities towards family, our children, parents, wife, husband, to the society. So these responsibilities are there. On top of that, when we take up the responsibility of practicing spirituality, of chanting Hare Krishna, suddenly first question comes is that 2 ghanta, 16 rounds karna hai, 2 ghanta karna hai, तो कैसे करें? ऑलरेडी वी आर टाइड अप विथ सो मेनी अदर थिंग्स, बट स्टिल हाउ शुड वी? देन वी टेक गाइडेंस फ्रॉम अ डिरेक्शन फ्रॉम द स्पिरिचुअल पर्सनैलिटीज. सो दिस इज द सेकेंड डी. फर्स्ट वॉज डिजायर, सेकेंड इज डिरेक्शन, एंड द थर्ड एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग वी लर्न फ्रॉम दिस पास टाइम इज द डिटर्मिनेशन, द क्वालिटी ऑफ डिटर्मिनेशन. सो किंग प्रताप रुद्र, ही हैड टू हियर सो मेनी नो यू नो निगेटिव फीडबैक्स दैट नो ही विल नॉट गेट अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मीट चैतन्य महाप्रभु. सो मेनी टाइम्स ही हैड टू हियर दिस. सो मेनी ऑब्स्टेकल्स केम, डिफिकल्टीज केम, बट ऑल्दो ही डिड नॉट गिव अप. Sometimes he felt like giving up the kingdom. Sometimes he felt like giving up his life also. But again, the direction was there. So this determination is very important. Even in the Rupa Goswami also tells in the Nectar of Instruction, Utsah, Nishchay, Dharya. So all these three things. He was doing things with enthusiasm, but just that enthusiasm is not sufficient. We need to have patience also. We need to have determination also. So these are the three principal qualities we see from the life of King Pratap Rudra. Now we will discuss the second king. We are going to discuss three kings, so now we'll discuss the second king, and the second king is none other than our dear Srila Prabhupada. Why he is a king? Although he is a sannyasi, he is a king who conquered this whole world by the same three principles. He was given the direction by his spiritual master, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Very specific direction. He said that this whole world, the whole India, Bharat Desh, is following Paschatya Desh, America. Whatever is happening in America, we just simply blindly follow. If Americans start wearing bell bottom, we'll also start wearing bell bottom. They'll start wearing narrow trousers, we also start following. So it's the same thing. So Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur says that you should go to the root cause, go to the Americans and preach to them this Krishna consciousness. So that direction was given by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And once that direction was given, Srila Prabhupada had developed that strong desire to preach this. And we all know, when normally people take retirement from their active life and just want to relax, he decided that I should go to America. And then the determination aspect also comes. At that age, he went on the Jaladvuta and had to face 3 heart attacks. He went to the US, and there also it was not so easy that okay, you come and you see it, there the Vyasasana was ready. It was not like that. He was just single person alone in America with 40 rupees in his hand. But in spite of all these things, he built the kingdom of ISKCON, across the whole world. 108 temples established. Now of course there are many more temples across the world, but he was the same king, you know, who conquered this world. So Srila Prabhupada, when he was small, at the age of 5, at that time he was seeing that his father was inviting so many saintly people at home, and he was also, Prabhupada was living in Calcutta, and he used to see the same festival of Jagannath Baldev Subhadra Rath Yatra festival. He used to see, and he also developed a desire that I should also conduct such Rath Yatra. So at the age of 5, he used to go and he used to approach different carpenters in near vicinity, that can you make rath for me? I want to have this. And they used to see that this small boy is there, and they still, okay, we'll make rath for you. But they used to never make rath. So once Srila Prabhupada, when he was small, he started crying. he started crying, and his father was like, what to do now? From where do I get rath for him? So he also approached some carpenters, but somehow nobody was ready to make. At that time, one old lady, she saw Prabhupada crying, and she asked his father that why this boy is crying. And he said that he wants to have Jagannath Rath Yatra, and he wants, for that he wants rath, but we don't have rath, so that's why he's crying. So she said, no, I have one rath. And Prabhupada's father immediately, you know, bought rath from this lady, this old lady. And then Prabhupada, he went, he bought oil paints from market, and he started painting the rath, just like how the raths are there in Jagannath Puri. He also started painting the rath, and he made very nice rath. And Prabhupada and his friends, young friends, small friends, all of them, they performed Nagar Sankirtan, and they pulled the rath. Prabhupada personally was performing kirtan, leading kirtan, and then they distributed prasad to all the devotees. So from such a small young age, Prabhupada had love for Jagannath Baladev Subhadra. And as we discuss, Srila Prabhupada went to America. Before going to America, Prabhupada was staying in Radha Damodar temple in Vrindavan. And that same Vrindavan was in his heart. He was carrying that Vrindavan in his heart at America also. And he was actually, just like the gopis, they were pulling the rath from Dwarka to Jagannath to Vrindavan. Prabhupada was also pulling the Lord with the invisible robes. He was pulling the Lord to Vrindavan, which was in his heart. And he wanted that Jagannath should come. And in 1967, in San Francisco, when Srila Prabhupada was sitting in his room, and Malati Mataji, she just came in Prabhupada's room, and she started telling Prabhupada that I went to a nearby shop, which is an import shop, and I went there and I found this small beautiful doll, and she removes this doll and keeps it in front on the table in front of Srila Prabhupada. And by seeing this beautiful doll, Srila Prabhupada immediately gets up and offers his obeisances, and he has tears in his eyes, and he says, Malati Devi, do you know what doll this is? This is none other than Jagannath Ji. So he said that there will be two more similar dolls. So Malati Mataji says, yeah, definitely there are two other dolls also. They are also similar, beautiful, colorful deities, colorful dolls. That time she did not know that they are deities, they are Lord. But she said, I did not have money. So the other devotees, they come together and they said, okay, now let us contribute and let us bring these small other dolls also. And they bring Baladev Ji and Subhadra Ji in front of Prabhupada. So Prabhupada is very pleased by seeing Jagannath Baladev Subhadra. And he says that if someone can make the similar big deities, they are small, 3 feet, small deities. So if someone can make similar big deities, then I will personally establish these deities in our temple in San Francisco. And this place will be then known as New Jagannath Puri. So at that time, Malati Mataji's husband, Shyam Sundar Prabhu, he comes forward and he says that I am a carpenter and I can carve this deities of Jagannath Baladev Subhadra. So few years, 2000 years back, the original pastime of Jagannath Baladev Subhadra, how they came, Indradumna Maharaj took help of Vishwakarma. Of course, nobody knew that he is Vishwakarma, but Vishwakarma personally came to carve these deities from the wooden log which he had received. So similarly, for Srila Prabhupada, Shyam Sundar Prabhu came as this Vishwakarma, and he carved the beautiful deities of Jagannath Baladev Subhadra and painted it. So there is nice pastime. That time Shyam Sundar Prabhu did not know who is Jagannath, and they did not know the etiquettes, and he used to smoke at that time, at that point of time. And one time he had kept a cigarette pack on front, on the head of Jagannath ji. He did not know what these deities are and all those things. So he had just kept, and Prabhupada just came, and he, with his stick, he just flipped it off, this cigarette pack, and told Shyam Sundar Prabhu that this, don't allow this cigarette pack to come in between you and Krishna. And that is the day Shyam Sundar Prabhu gave up smoking. And the deities were carved and beautiful installation took place. And the same year, the devotees, they decided that they should have Rath Yatra on the instruction of Srila Prabhupada. So Srila Prabhupada gave them guidance, and the devotees, that time they did not have Rath, but they organized for a flatbed truck, and they kept the deities on the truck. They did decoration, beautiful decorations. And these Westerners, they know that they may not have flowers and all these things, but they put a lot of balloons and so many things. And they cooked prasad, they started distributing prasad and so many things. And then the kirtan was going on, and Prabhupada was so pleased by seeing the enthusiasm of these Western devotees in San Francisco. So this was the first Rath Yatra in 1967, and probably the first outside Jagannath Puri, you know, in the Western world. So it's a revolutionary concept, you know, which Prabhupada established. And then thereafter, so many countries, so many places, we have Jagannath Rath Yatras now. Today only I received one video, small video clip, and in that it was shown that the Jagannath, Baldev and Subhadra ji, they come in a Ferrari car in some Western world. Of course, in Jagannath Puri, they come in a traditional way, they come, but other places, the bhav is the same. There is no ordinary car in which Jagannath, they are the Jagannath, the Lord of the universe. So they have to have the best of the cars if they have to come. So they don't come on a normal Fiat or Maruti, you know, they come in this. So like that, and so many places now the Rath Yatra is going on. We see in our city of Mumbai also, now we have 4 temples. Radha Gopinath ji, Radha Ras Bihari, Radha Giridhari, and Radha Madan Mohan now in Kargar. So many, and apart from that also, so many Rath Yatras are going on. So devotees, now people have so much of opportunity to receive the mercy of Lord Jagannath. There is not only one Rath Yatra which will take place only Jagannath Puri. Now it is everywhere, and different time, different places it is happening. So as Prabhuji was mentioning, I have now opportunity to see the Jagannath Rath Yatra every day in Bhaktivedanta Hospital. So a very unique and revolutionary thing, where we have small Jagannath Baldev Subhadra, they are on a small cart and on a wheel. They go every day, they go to all the wards, and all the patients who are not able to even get up from their seat, they get to see darshan of Jagannath Baldev Subhadra. Now earlier, like what we discussed, that how Lord Jagannath Baldev Subhadra comes out to see, to give their darshan, here now Jagannath Baldev Subhadra, because of the extra compassion of devotees, they are even going to give darshan to all these patients, the doctors, visitors, whoever is coming there, they are getting the opportunity to see the Rath Yatra here. So now we will discuss the third king of today's this class. And the third king is the king of Rath Yatra, and his name is His Grace Jayanand Prabhu, the disciple of Srila Prabhupada. So Jayanand Prabhu He came in Krishna consciousness in 1967, where the first Rath Yatra, which is very coincident, you know. He had so much love for the Jagannath Baldev Subhadra and for Rath Yatra festival. He came in Krishna consciousness. Before that, he was a mechanical engineer. He was from a very well-to-do family. But in spite of being a mechanical engineer and well-to-do family, he used to drive taxis. He was a cab driver. Because naturally he just wanted to be humble and simple. And when he met Srila Prabhupada and the disciples, other disciples of Srila Prabhupada, he immediately took up to Krishna consciousness. And he was the great instrument in the first Rath Yatra in San Francisco, which took place. Afterwards, when Srila Prabhupada needed some amount, some Lakshmi for some services, immediately Jayanand Prabhu gave up. He had earned $5,000. That was his earning for the life. He gave up all that to Srila Prabhupada for the services. And he used to be backbone of all the Rath Yatras. He had a strong desire. Again, now we come back, go to the three principles of desire, direction and determination. Now he has got direction given by Srila Prabhupada, and he had developed a strong desire to have Rath Yatras in all major cities of America. So he decided to construct Rath Yatra cart. At that point of time, there are no place to store. So every time they had to make new rath, then assemble again, back in a garage or something, and then again next year again they had to build another rath. So every place he used to go, and he used to construct this rath. And not only creating of or constructing this rath, but he would also do other services related to Rath Yatra. Now, 1 year I was part of one of the services of Ghatkopar Rath Yatra. Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu had involved me in some services, and usme purva pasina nikal gaya. You know, I said, next time I told Prabhuji, only one service I can do. But Jayanand Prabhu was doing so many services. He used to cook also, he used to collect funds, he used to beg for food, fruits, flowers, engage everyone in the services. And some of the qualities which Jayanand Prabhu had, which we'll just discuss on that. One quality was humility. He was actually practicing the third verse of Shikshashtakam, Trunadapi Sunichena, Tarori Vasahishnana, Amanina Manadina, Kirtaniya Sadhari. So if anyone used to praise him for anything, he used to just go away from that place. He'll never stand there for a minute also. Because his only aim was to serve. He has no other aim. Once one boy, young boy, came there, and Jayanand Prabhu used to take care of garbage, cleaning of garbage and taking care of the whole garbage thing. And he came and met, and Jayanand Prabhu engaged him in also services. And later on he became a devotee, and then he told that, when I saw Jayanand Prabhu for the first time, I saw that he is a person who takes care of a garbage. And if this person is so happy and enthusiastic, then what would be the case of other devotees? So by seeing Jayanand Prabhu, this boy became devotee. And how was his service attitude? Whenever there is a leftover prasad, he is to clean the whole entire kitchen, and he is to put all this leftover prasad in the van, and he is to just take it to different places. He is to perform sankirtan there and distribute prasad. And while distributing prasad, he used to make other people devotees. And he was not catching hold of somebody who is like, very well-to-do person. He will even catch hold of some hippies or drug addicts or who are lying on the side of the road. He used to bring them and make them devotees. Like that, so many people got the mercy of Jayanand Prabhu. In spite of being a senior devotee also, he always wanted to do menial services. So when the famous Radha Damodar Kirtan party, the bus party was going, he took up the service of being the driver. And he used to drive all these devotees who were much younger to him, but he used to take them and for various services at various places. And he was very expert. So sometime he's doing building the rath, sometimes he used to go in a kitchen and make nice prasad for everyone. And he had one good quality, of another good quality was he used to not find faults in anyone. He used to neither criticize anyone, or if anyone is criticizing some other devotee, he used to just get up from that place and go away. So that is the wonderful quality of Jayanand Prabhu. And he was very dear to all, not only to the devotees, but people outside in general also. So once one devotee was telling that in San Francisco, they had to go and meet public relation people, officers, government officials, and take their permission to conduct Rath Yatra. So one lady was there, who was part of that government officers, and this lady was very tough lady, and she used to never cooperate with devotees. But when next time, after a few years, when devotees went to meet her and to take the permission, she asked, "Where is Jayanand? I want to meet Jayanand." So devotees told that, "No, unfortunately, Jayanand Prabhu left his body, he is no more." So this tough lady, she started crying. So all the devotees also became very astonished that how this lady will not budge by anyone, was so moved by Jayanand Prabhu's departure. So Jayanand Prabhu also had some mystic opulences, also mystic powers. He used to work so hard, especially during the Rath Yatra time. He used to work so hard, he used to just sleep for only 3 hours. And still, he will be very fresh next day and performing various hard services. It is not like standing at one place and giving orders to others that do this, do this, that. No, he used to personally come and do the services. He had a great appetite. So it is said that, it is told that, he could consume buckets of halwa, butter halwa, and samosas. These also were his favorite things. And aisa nahi ki matlab after having this next day is like, stomach upset. No, he used to be with the same enthusiasm. It is told that in his last days, he was in the hospital and he was on IV, and still he used to tell the devotees to sneak some cheese potatoes and samosas and all those things, and he used to have this without any side effects. Of course, we cannot imitate these things. Another thing which he also had the capacity and capability was, because he used to work so hard, sometimes in the class he used to go off to sleep, which happens to us naturally. I can also see sometimes this happens. I also experience this. But when he used to get up, the class is over, and he could repeat the whole class without any missing any point. That is his capacity. Now that doesn't happen to us. unless there is a joke which is cracked or there is Mahaprasade which is chanted, we don't get up. So, but that was one of these, you know, some mystic, wonderful opulences. So Jayanand Prabhu was in the movement only for 10 years. 1967 he came and 1977 he left this world. And he was, last few months before he left his body, he was identified with the most dangerous disease, leukemia, blood cancer. And he was suffering a lot. It was very painful for him. And in spite of being into this condition also, his services did not stop. And last few months, he came to Los Angeles. And in Los Angeles, he inspired the devotees. At that point of time, Los Angeles, there was not a single Rath Yatra. It was the biggest congregation in America at that point of time. Many devotees were there. And he inspired all the devotees that you should have Rath Yatra here. And he went, in that condition, he said, I will take care of this. He guided devotees how to construct the Rath. At some point of time, he was on wheelchair. And still, he was going and with the hammer and nails, he was helping to build the Rath. So that was the dedication, that was the sacrifice which he was doing and inspiring devotees. He took the permission, he was admitted in the hospital. From there, he used to call up people, government officials, and take permissions and guide devotees and to go and do things for the Rath Yatra. So this, when I was reading this particular thing, one thing which was amazing, that when he came, the Rath Yatra, the first Rath Yatra, which was San Francisco, which is also known as New Jagannath Puri. And Los Angeles is known as New Dwarka. So his journey started in Jagannath Puri and his journey ended in Dwarka. So again, some small correlation of this Jagannath Rath Yatra. And such was the life of Jayanand Prabhu, which was very inspiring. By looking at his life, we can see that, you know, how these three, the strong desire, determination, I mean, imagine in this condition, you know, having a leukemia and from the hospital, still he's doing this. So we can also take inspiration from such great personalities. We discussed about, just summarize, I'll conclude now. We discussed about the significance of Rath Yatra, then the life of these three kings, King Pratap Rudra, Srila Prabhupada and Jayanand Prabhu, and how they lived the life of desire, spiritual desires for serving the devotees and serving the Lord. Determination, strong determination in spite of difficulties, doing that, and always taking the shelter and of direction of saintly personalities or their spiritual masters. So I'll conclude here, because many devotees, they may want to go to Mira Road for today's Rath Yatra. And it is important that if we can also be personally take part in this Rath Yatra festival and serve the Lord by pulling the Rath and try to bring the Lord in our heart, cleanse our heart. So the both mercy and endeavor which can be practiced. So if we can participate personally, it is good. If or by any chance, if you are not, then we have various opportunities to participate at various times, various places within Mumbai also. If not, we can see it live, this Rath Yatra festival. Today, technology is such that, you know, we are able to participate for even sitting at one place. Earlier, so many years back, we did not have the facility to hear the lectures. Once we miss the lecture in temple, then we are not able to hear that again. But now, by the mercy of ISKCON Desire Tree, we can see it sometimes live, sometimes you can see those lectures later on. And now, of course, ISKCON Desert, they have come out with a TV channel also. So this Rath Yatra is going to be shown on one of the channels of this Hare Krishna TV. Or Vaishnav Seva Prabhu has done wonderful service of creating this channel. We can see that live on that. So many opportunities are there. So only thing is that we need to have that strong desire to take shelter of the spiritual desires and not the material desires. So I'll end here. Thank you very much. So Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Shri Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Maya ki jai. So if there is any question, one question we can probably take. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Hare Krishna, request the devotees to kindly stay back for a few minutes, one or two announcements. Kindly remain seated. Hare Krishna. So first we would like to express our gratitude to His Grace Sudhir Chaitanya Prabhu for taking us through this beautiful